Hello everyone and welcome to this video. This is the 10 more ideas for search and rescue missions that I talked about in the previous video, and I'm super excited to present them to you here. I thought about them long and hard, as well as read all the comments in the video that I made last time talking about the 10 first ideas, and actually I have some even more things to add based on discussions that were brought up by other members. Overall, I really enjoyed all the comments. Thank you to all that commented. There was a lot of great ideas. However, in addition to that, there was also some other interesting thoughts too. So here in this case, the user mentioned that there's already similar things like find the missing person and disaster evacuation. While there are, there's not really the arrangement I've showed where it's like a flight plan or sort of a more like a treasure map to find them rather than just appearing on the map, but that's okay, close enough. What is quite interesting is that they suggested an unknown call. So you just get called out, say, you know, there's a situation out here and you have to go and find out what it is. So that was quite interesting. There was talks of smuggling missions, which is interesting, stopping a fast boat. I actually have that in another video planned, and that would be more like a suggestion for some sort of law enforcement style missions. But this one was really neat. So this user actually said that they think they shouldn't add any more missions, and honestly, great explanation. I did enjoy this. So the user thinks that they should add the ability to expand the modding editing capabilities to allow better users to actually make new missions and objectives. That way users, or people that want to, you know, develop the game further, not the developers, but just modders, can make these missions and objectives and leave the game for the developers for, you know, improving, enhancing, adding things to the core game. So in that case, I actually do agree that I think that's a great idea, but that actually brought me to thinking, you know, I didn't actually have my standard disclaimer, which is, you know, this video is just for fun. I don't actually, whether I support or not these ideas, the video is purely for entertainment and just purely for information to the developers. They can take it as they see fit. There's other comments talking about bigger fires, other people wanting pirate missions, drug intercepting missions, and all kinds of stuff. So as well as evacuating more people, that could be fun and, you know, incentive to build bigger ships. But at the same time, that is also, you know, a bit tricky maybe on the graphics. I don't know, maybe the developers can make a way to make it work. So really good interaction from everybody who watched the previous video, and here are 10 more ideas that I thought of. Ghost ship and abandoned vessel salvage. Now maybe I've just been reading too many Dirk Pitt novels, but I always find ghost ships fascinating. I just think there's something inherently awesome and amazing of something that's just been kind of lost to the sea, and now you have the ability to be the first one aboard and to explore it. So in this case, you'd have to have a model of a vessel that is, you know, fairly intricate but not necessarily as large as the MV Cocker, just something that, you know, you have a bit more space to explore. And what you'd be doing here is you'd be hopping aboard and taking a look at what is going on in here. Now there could be a few different things aboard that you may be faced with. So as you kind of explore this abandoned vessel, especially if it's nighttime, you know, you may not have access to lighting and you may have to use your flashlight, all that stuff. It's a fully abandoned vessel. In this case, I didn't turn off my abandoned lights, but maybe they're even creepy. They're kind of blinking. So what I envision for this type of thing is the ship is listing and your task is to stop it. So it'd almost be like a mini mission type of situation where you have to maybe find a button or find a valve in this vessel. And not only that, you may come across some compartments that are flooded and that you can no longer enter. Imagine you come to a passage like this that's fully flooded. So that'd be part of the mission, that you come to a fully flooded area and then you have to dive through and potentially, you know, go through the vessel and find where this breaker or whatever is that you can then turn. It'd be extra nice if the ship actually does take on more water. For example, if it has like a pump that's constantly pumping, and eventually it does turn over and sink, so it pretty much forces you to work as quick as possible to find the valve or whatever it may be to stop it from sinking. Now, maybe it's difficult with the vessel, a vessel the size of this, but I do like to, you know, think that some sort of abandoned vessel exploration is quite interesting and intriguing in itself, especially if it's a really stormy, dark day and you're kind of aboard a very eerie ship. You don't even need any AI, you just need the ship itself, pretty much. Or you just tow it to a base, so could also be the salvage in the case of you towing it and returning it. But I think we already have towing missions enough, so this would be more fun if it's more like an exploration or find the something or retrieve the something from the ship. Obstacle tow and recovery. And I know what you're thinking, we already have, you know, towing vessels, but that's not what I mean. Say we come across an obstacle such as an iceberg or a downed plane or other type of wreckage or, you know, things in the water, and now we have to tow them to safety to get them out of the shipping path. So in this case, it would work possibly where we have, you know, an area that we have to just tow it out of. Obviously with wreckage, you wouldn't tow it out of an area, you'd have to tow it to an actual facility. But imagine if it's an iceberg and you could just attach it on and tow it to a location where it doesn't end up bothering anyone. That's kind of what I envision this mission. So it's towing things or you know, transporting things that are a little clunkier than, call it, your run-of-the-mill vessel that we're used to towing. Because, of course, towing vessels is a little bit, I mean, it's not too difficult. You just have to have a ship powerful enough. But it'd be more interesting to think, all right, how can I tow something that is not really buoyant and not really, you know, straightforward. Like an iceberg, you may need a bunch of magals, like a real operation, or something like this, you may actually need a recovery vessel, not just a simple boat to tow it. But let's see how that actually works in this case. Oh, well, we're towing it easy enough for now. But something along these lines where it's not really a vessel and it's also like half sunk and you got to get it out of here, especially if it's hazardous conditions, especially if you have to have multiple tow points. Like in the case of this, we have that nice point on the front, but what if we had to attach it to one of the wings? Or what if there was no point of attachment and we actually had to use magals? So something more like recovery, obstacle towing, that type of thing. Speaking of obstacle recovery, what about mines? Everyone knows that mines were a big problem in the ocean after the World Wars, and with them now here in Stormworks, they add an extra element of sort of care while you indeed do try to tow them to a place of safety. Now, if you touch any of the prongs, it would explode. So we do have in the game already that kind of acceleration meter or something. So you'd have to be very, very careful when dealing with these. Alternatively, you could also stand back and shoot at it to explode it, and that would also render it neutral, obviously. But you'd have to be fairly distant from it in order to prevent damage to your own vessel. But I'd imagine recovering it and bringing it somewhere would be better for your, would get you more money. But you could see it would be quite difficult to prevent yourself from touching it, so you don't want to, you know, hit into anything. And that kind of adds that other little bit of element, especially here in the game. Environmental monitoring. So everyone knows, or hopefully everyone knows, one of my biggest factions is OMA, who is a research organization. They do all kinds of marine and seawater research, but it'd be quite interesting if inside our inventory here we actually got, in addition to the various sensors we have to monitor the, you know, the temperature and whatever, that we would have some sort of probes, kind of like this temperature probe, but it would also be a general all-inclusive environmental probe. It would detect if there is oil in the seawater, it would detect if there's pollutants, maybe the amount of fish nearby, something along these lines. And we would actually have to go around the map to set points on the map and collect water samples, track pollution, and potentially clean up any oil spills, that type of thing. So you'd have to actually travel to various parts, and maybe they'd all be kind of flashing like they do when you have, you know, certain things like how we have these safe zones here. Maybe we'd have a bunch of flashing areas that we go, and everyone we go to and collect the information, we get paid. So this would kind of be a little bit slower paced, but it would definitely give us that environmental aspect that we could go and track and make sure everything is good and dandy in our Stromworks world here. Submarine rescue. Now, I do know that the developers at some point added some underwater style rescue missions. I'm not exactly sure what they are because I've never seemed to come across them, but it'd be quite interesting to receive an underwater rescue where we'd have to go and rescue crew members trapped on a submerged submarine. In this case, you could either use a massive salvage vessel to lift up that submarine before their air runs out, or we could use our own submersible, go down there and possibly use airlocks, maybe even provide an air supply if there's like a hose connection piece that we could attach ours to and then give them an air supply while we evacuate them. So that'd be quite interesting, especially the various types of vehicles and rescue platforms that would encourage to build and kind of give us that extra little bit of creativity in addition to the game, what it already offers. What goes hand in hand with submarine rescue? Well, research station that is underwater. So imagine there is a large underwater research station, sort of like the one we have in the Arctic on the island, but actually this one is underwater, so they'd have to add one new element to the game. And in that, we have to then go and use a submarine with a docking station to attach ourselves, get in there. Maybe there's flooding, maybe we have to use some sort of diving gear to get to it, go through an airlock, and then rescue the people that are on board. Again, I know the developers aren't too keen on changing the world at all or changing the map, but I do think that something like that would be more or less a viable part of the game, especially if you consider the fact that we already have a lot of creations that they could potentially borrow from those people that have made them. And then with that, we'd be able to just put it on the bottom of the ocean, and or not even on the bottom of the ocean, just floating kind of in situ on an area here, and we'd get to it and get in and save those people. That leads me to the next one, which is underwater wreck exploration. Now, quite similar to the one where I just mentioned where we have a submarine, except now we're not actually rescuing anybody. We're just going down to a wreck site, and we all know there are several here in the map, but we would go down to the wreck site, whether we use equipment like this, submarines, or just dive down and recover equipment. Whether we recover something that's small, I know currently they have the treasure chests, but it'll be quite neat to have to actually do some salvage, maybe bring something up, or even go down there and sort of navigate the wreck, maybe find some interactive elements that we can press on or do something to then accomplish our tasks there. Documentation check. So just like the Coast Guard or any type of marine service, you go and board vessels and check their registration. Now, what this would entail, presumably, would be some sort of way to make the vessels stop. I know they mentioned they're not going to do any changes to the AI, but this would just be one of those things where maybe a certain alarm would actually cause other vessels to stop, and we would sort of be the de facto Coast Guard. And when we jump aboard, at that point, we can check their documentation. That would just be something as simple as, you know, going to the whoever is operating the vessel and just walking up to them, interacting with them, and walking away. However, to add a spin to things, this could be related to that sort of AI I mentioned with the pirates, where if you go up to the person and ask them for documentation, they may start shooting at you or some other type of thing like that. So a little bit more AI related. I wouldn't say they have to run and do some crazy things, but just sort of a bit of interaction with the various people that are exploring and walking around and traveling our beautiful Stromworks land. So it would just be a little bit of AI and kind of that Coast Guard style operation. Hazardous material cleanup. So in this case, we get called to respond to a leak of radioactive equipment or material. So in this case, we got to get our full hazmat gear and make our way to this vessel that has been deemed radioactive. Maybe it's a nuclear powered ship, just like what we have here, except it's leaked. So we have to find a way to get aboard, stay safe with our hazmat outfit, maybe grab a box or something in that vessel that is radioactive, and then take it to a place or otherwise deposit it somewhere on the map. Maybe there's a way to deposit them properly, maybe we just sort of take it and remove it somewhere, but that would be up to the developers. My idea is just something along the lines of utilizing the fact we have all this radioactive gear, and of course we do have the one part of the map that has the radioactive factory here, but it would be neat to get it in terms of the rescue missions. Now, while they're not all different in nature just by these elements, it just makes sure you have to be prepared. So your vessel could be equipped to tackle hazmat related issues. Maybe it can tow, maybe it can salvage, maybe it can do all of them. And then you have yourself something really neat that can kind of be used in a multitude of different scenarios. But end of the day, it's just a game where you could, you know, put your creativity to the test and maybe accomplish some tasks while you're at it. And the Maritime Patrol Search and Rescue. So in this case, it's not an existing mission, but rather a set of objectives that we could go and accomplish around the map. So earlier I mentioned sort of a research style mission where you have to go to a waypoint here, and collect various data, and that gets you paid collecting this data. Well, in the career mode, I know people sometimes have a problem trying to make a lot of money, and I think that if we were to have a job, whether we go to a place and register to be Coast Guards, for example, at the Coast Guard outpost, we register for the mission, and then waypoints appear on the map that we have to go to, and that's part of our patrol. So we could go to these various areas, and it gets us paid. This way, it'll just pay for our fuel, it pays for our time, and that way we could, maybe as we get to a certain area, it activates a certain mission, such as I mentioned with the pirates or the boarding of vessels, or otherwise it just gives you an objective to cruise point to point and sort of deal with things as the time proceeds. Maybe if it's terrible conditions, you get more money, maybe not. Just something kind of open-ended that you could do and pass the time in career mode, get you paid while also giving you something to kind of do in between. Like you wouldn't have to wait statically for a mission to appear on the map. It would just kind of be an objective that you have, so you're on your way there and then something may appear. That's more or less what happens in real life. You know, these guys are going from place to place and then they get called out something. So it would just sort of be that, in essence, maritime patrol, where you could end up getting called and summoned to another situation that you could then handle. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for more videos. Stay tuned for more content. I can't wait to see what you thought of this video. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you have any other ideas, suggestions, or anything else. I do love making videos like this. As I mentioned in the disclaimer, I'm not necessarily saying this is something the developers should do, have to do, or even that it would be good for the game. I'm purely making content and thinking what would be pretty cool. In the meantime, here is a quick behind the scenes look at my next larger creation. It's going to be for Alta, and it's going to be sort of a passenger or crew train. So stay tuned for this, and until next time, happy storm rixing, everyone.